Good morning, everybody. I have an enormous amount of primary elements I mixed in the past few months, and I really have a lot of leftovers. So I was thinking, why not do a flip cup? I have a very big cup here, and I was thinking I want to put in some silicone oil, or dimethicone oil in this case, but you can use silicone oil, dimethicone oil. There are a lot of oils you can use for this. And these primary elements are pigments, and they are all mixed with the Vivid Polypore. If you look below my video in the comment section or in the subscription box, there are links to color art. It's all color art. I sell them in my webshop, and color art sells them themselves. So these are all metallic paints, or paints with mica in it, or color shift. They're really fun. Okay, I hope you can see there's not much left. They are just small cups. So in some colors I will just put 3 drops of that dimethicone oil and mix that through. I'm going to do that now in a couple of different colors, and I will be back when we are going to fill this flip cup. Okay, here we are again. I have put in most of the colors the dimethicone oil or the silicone oil. I also have iridescent paints, and I think it might look just like white to you, but this is bright white with a green shift. I have white, it's not white, but this will give a blue shift, and I have a violet and a green and a gold, and they will also go in there. I also mixed up some black paint. This is golden carbon black, and there's a little bit of Australian Floetrol in it, and a little bit of polyurethane varnish. And here's not dimethicone in it. I'm just going to fill this cup up with the colors, and I will mention the colors while I will pour them in. This is the Royal Satin. I am just going to finish these cups. Because you can save these colors, but they will thicken up a little. That's because our containers are, of course, not airtight. If they were airtight, you can save them a lot longer, but not in this kind of jars. And what I do when they are a little bit thickened up, I just mix in a little bit of water or a little bit of varnish or whatever you have might have left. This is the lemon drop. And you know what, guys, I will fast forward this from now on. I will just put the colors below the video, because this will take way too long. Okay, well, here's my flip cup. I think we have way too much paint, but we'll see. It's kind of a heavy, I don't know if you can see it.
Yeah, yes.
Okay. And I'm going to lift my canvas first, and then I will put it upside down. And it can very well be that this will turn out all too much. I don't know. And don't expect cells like where you would use only acrylic paint, tube paint, because that reacts very different than the primary elements. And that's because they all have mica or some metallic. Okay guys, here we go. Ooh. It looks nice, but I should have used a bigger canvas.
Told you.
It looks beautiful. Oh, you want to see my empty cup? Look at that. So I'm going to torch it now with a fire torch. There comes fire out of this. And see if we can get some cells, because I do see already some pretty cells developing. But we also want to get rid of air bubbles. Wow, this is gorgeous.
Yeah, just leave it.
Yeah, I don't have to tilt very much. This is so gorgeous. I'm going to tilt this very, very slow. And I'm so sorry, I'm probably going to lose that, but that's just beautiful. Okay, next time I will use a bigger canvas. Oh, there it goes, you see. I'm so sorry that I lost that. But it's actually really fun doing flip cups with primary elements, because it really looks gorgeous. I'm just sorry that I'm going to lose quite a lot of paint. I think it's over a year ago that I did a flip cup, you guys. I'm trying to move this very slow. I need it to go over the corners. Wow, those colors are amazing. And there go my big cells. But this looks so beautiful. I'm really happy I tried this. And I have done a flip cup once with primary elements when I just got to know them. That's when Leslie Onstedt, the owner of Color Art, sent me a couple of jars to test for her. And I was so impressed when I first used them. And when I see stuff like this, I'm very impressed again. Okay, I think I will torch it just one more time. This, and then I'm going to give you a close-up. Oh. Because we need to get rid of the air bubbles. And you know, primary elements are transparent or semi-transparent, and that's why this is giving such a gorgeous effect. But I'm going to show it to you right now. Okay, here we are for the close-up. I'm showing you now with just my normal lights on, but I will show you after this with my flash on so you can see the colors better. But just look how pretty and gorgeous this is. I love it. I'm sorry that I wasted so much paint, because I was really not planning to. So I still have a lot of paint left. I will do a flip cup probably next week with a larger canvas. But I just love it that you can Just throw in all these colors, even with black in it, and it never turns to mud. Okay guys, I will be back now with my flash on and the lights on. Okay, here I am with my flash on so you can see. That's really the only way I can show you. Yeah, that metallic and that mica popping out of there. I'm just going to tilt my phone a little bit now. Okay, now you can see. Is that gorgeous or what? And look at those funky cells. It looks like there's something flying in space. And can you see all that colored shimmer and mica? It just gives such a special effect, and that's because they are transparent. So if one layer goes over the other layer, you can see through them. And that's what's giving this effect. And I just love this. I'm sorry. It's just so hard to show you. I will make some photos so you can see the images without me moving, but I hope you can see what I mean, how gorgeous these colors are. I know it looks pretty dark, it's already evening here. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I want to thank you for watching this video. I want to show you my leftover in the flip cup. Wait. It's so gorgeous. And well, if you haven't subscribed, please do. I try to make a video every week, sometimes twice a week. And I will be back this week with decorating Christmas ornaments. That's what I started with earlier this week, but I need to finish the back of those ornaments. So I will be back. I wish you a great weekend. Bye bye.